x0 and x1 are given by f2 into x0, x2 plus d of 2 operated on right on x2 x This is for 4 samples. What does this tell you? This tells you that this should be, x0, x1 are obtained by operating f2 on even samples and again operating f2 on odd samples, but further operated by the D matrix, which is a diagonal matrix. And similarly, once you obtain this, this and this, the other two are obtained by just the same term with a minus sign here. And this is what I was trying to prove in the last class at the end. That the half of them will be obtained as equal to other half, but for a minus sign. So what does this pictorially represent? This pictorially represents, you take x0 and x2, operate on f2. What is my f2 equal to? 1, 1, 1 omega square, right? What is omega square equal to? Minus 1. So, when you multiply this, you get this plus this and this minus this, right? So, this is nothing but capital. Not correcting. Capital X0, X1 is equal to X0 plus X2, X0 minus X2. That is the first term. Second term is also similar. Multiplied by D matrix. And what is my D matrix? 1, 0. 1, 0. 0, 0. 0, W. Similarly, X2 and X3 are equal to the same one that here minus the same one . What is this operation? This operation given x0 and x2, you sum them up and difference them up. This operation is given x1, x3, sum them up and difference them up. In first Fourier transform representation, they call this butterfly operation. Which is denoted by if A and B are there, this is the butterfly, and the upper arm is A plus B, and the lower arm is A minus B. So this operation is known as the butterfly in the literature. So that means you put x0 here and x2 here, and this butterfly will give you automatically this. And this another butterfly here, which gives you same thing for x1 and x3. So this is one butterfly, this is same butterfly, another butterfly, same butterfly. Only thing is, now this has to be pre-multiplied by this and pre-multiplied by same thing here. So now the whole operation in terms of butterfly can be written down as equal to diagrammatically. Shuffled values put one butterfly here, put one butterfly here, that takes care of these two. And then if you call this as x prime 0, via media x, that is this term, this term, this term and this term. This need to be multiplied by this fellow. So if you do that, x0 there's one more butterfly here. In between, you need to do some multiplications. This has to be multiplied by omega 4 to the power of 0, and this has multiplied by omega 4 to the power of 1, which is basically this D matrix multiplication is nothing but 1 is omega 4 to the power of 0, and this omega is equal to nothing but omega 4 to the power of 1. So to multiply this by this, multiply this by this, and then they go to the various wings of the butterfly, and out comes here x0, x1, x2, x3. Okay, now see the beauty of this diagram. Butterfly is only sum and difference, and we have agreed complex number addition, complex number, some differencing doesn't take much time. The only problem comes in multiplying by a complex number. That takes more time. If you look at this, this butterfly is a addition summation, addition summation, addition summation, addition summation. And how many stages of butterflies are there? Two stages of butterfly. And why is 2 here? Because 4 is equal to 2 square. If you are generally 2 to the power of p, there will be p stages of butterflies. And how many butterflies are there in this direction? Again 2. Again it is because of 2 to the power of 2. So in general you have a p by p butterfly. But all the operations in the butterfly are summations or subtractions. I mean addition of 2 numbers or subtraction by 2 numbers. So there is no time consuming. Where is the time consuming then? Time consuming is coming into this multiplication. And see that this multiplication is really only one arm here. In the case of 4, you will have more number of such arms. In the worst case, it doesn't happen. But we assume the worst case that all of these are multiplied by complex numbers, like you are multiplying by here. How many complex additions will be there? Multiplication, n number, multiplied by number of stages, p is the number of stages. So the total complex multiplication, the worst, it never happens. But then a maximum ever number will be, it is not even maximum number, that means the u is equal to n times p, which is equal to n log n. A much less than that. Because the multiplications like this will only come in previous stages. And as you go down, this thing, number of multiplication will go on, complex only decreasing actually. But assuming that all of them are being multiplied by a complex number, even real number like 1, you consider it as a complex, and assuming that every one of them is being multiplied, this is the worst case complex multiplications.